Hi everyone, Sandra Vale here, Homesteading Ways. And today I am going to show you how I get my dish rags or dishcloth clean without using any kind of bleach. You can also do it with other whites, only you'd need to do it on a little bit bigger of a scale, but we'll talk about that in a minute. Alrighty, the first thing you're going to want to do is get your soap. This is Fell's Naphtha. You can use Zote or Ivory, whatever it is you choose to use. I like Fell's Naphtha because it works really good on laundry and stains and stuff. And I have mine going already, but you're just going to shave off little bits to go in there and let it melt up. And once it has melted, then I add a little bit of borax. Not a lot, you don't need a lot, but it is a kind of like a booster. It works good in your laundry and it helps to brighten stuff up. And once you see these rags, you'll know why I'm doing this. Just mix it around a little bit in there, just so that it melts in. All right, and then you're going to want to grab your rags. This one's pretty dirty, but that's nothing compared to my other one. Hang on here. Get it all the way in there. Now usually I use a bigger pot, but I have these two that are really disgusting, so I'm doing this today. Look at this one. It is just horrible. My husband likes to put rags in the sink and then dump coffee over them for some reason. Well, after that, my son went and took this and washed off some dusty table whatever up in his room. So now it's really bad. So we're going to put that in there too. And I'm not going to boil the water, at least not yet. You're just going to let it sit, let it move around. If you have spots on there that are really bad, like a particular stain you want to make sure to get off, then just take your bar of soap and rub it in there real good. Sometimes I'll take a toothbrush or a nail brush and scrub it real good just to get that out of there. If it's something maybe greasy or dark, like see on here, it seems like it always gets a little embedded on those edges. So you can do that. You can get it wet and let it sit out here if you want, or just put it right back in there. It should work. Now I'm going to let this go for maybe, 10 or 15 minutes, just at a low level. Let it kind of not even simmer, but just warm up real good. And then I'm going to turn the heat up and add my last little ingredients. Okay, now it's almost at the boiling point. But right before we get there, I did want to say that I did pull this one rag out before it got too hot. And I did scrub down with my bottle brush here some spots that looked kind of bad, you know, that they may not have gotten out all on their own. Sometimes the soap and stuff in here will really help to loosen things up, you know, but you still need that friction to try and make sure you're going to get it all out of there. But the water is pretty darn hot right now. So when it gets to this point of where it's almost boiling, it's kind of at simmer level right there. Then I'm going to take hydrogen peroxide and put that in there. You don't need a lot, especially in a pot this small. You just pour a little bit in there. You don't want to do it before the boiling point. Like, see, right now you're not seeing a whole lot of, action going on or something. But you will, and you normally don't see it until it gets to the boiling point. And then it could boil over. So once you see it starting to boil pretty good, turn it down again. You can let it simmer. It just depends on, you know, how dirty your stuff is. Now, if you want to whiten sheets or a whole load of socks and t-shirts, something like that, when you're doing your laundry in the washing machine, this is what I do. I let the machine fill up halfway with water and my soap. Then I add my stuff and I'm using hot water. I add all my clothing, I let it finish filling, I let it agitate for 30 seconds, a minute, and then I stop it and I let it sit. Then I go and I get something about this size here. I think this holds about a gallon. I boil up water and I add it to my wash water. If you want to stop your machine shortly before it gets to full and then add your boiling water, that's fine too. But add as much hot boiling water as you can to the washing machine. Now see how it's coming up? It's boiling, and now you see this? That's when you'll see the hydrogen peroxide starting to really work. But in your washing machine, then let it sit, I'd say 15, 20 minutes, half an hour if you can. Then add your peroxide and start the wash cycle. Just continue on the way you normally would. Your clothes will come out a lot brighter, especially your whites. If you can hang them outside, even better. The sun really helps to bleach them. I just don't like using bleach on my clothes. It started, geez, almost 30 years ago when my oldest son had a bad reaction to it. So ever since then, I just didn't use it. Okay, so now I'm going to let this go. I turned it down, because if I would have kept it at a higher boil like that, it would have boiled over. But you can see how the hydrogen peroxide is bubbling up and really working on it. So I'm going to let this go, I don't know, maybe 5-10 minutes. And then when it's done, I'm just going to pour it all out, rinse it out, and then let them air dry, and I'll show you how they turned out. Okay, they're all done. They're dry. And this is how they came out. The one on the right is the one that was super filthy dirty. And it's not, you know, nearly as bright as the one on the left. But it's still pretty good to me. And the colors of the stripes are still nice. And I can continue to use it. And that's just how I brighten my stuff without using bleach. I appreciate you watching the video. I'm glad you took the time to do it. Comment, subscribe, thumbs up. That'd be awesome. It was nice talking to you, and you take care.